Hello and welcome to Hamer Reviews. My name is Christopher Hamer and today we're reviewing the Bowers & Wilkins T7 wireless speaker. I'm quite a big fan of wireless speakers. They're convenient, you can move them from room to room, you can take them outside. Generally speaking, it's a great way of getting much better audio than your phone can handle anywhere you like. This speaker has actually been around for over 5 years, so it's getting on a bit. The reason why I thought it'd be interesting to review it is it's still available for practically its full retail price of £250 today. And a lot of stores are still stocking it. But in my opinion, there's a huge amount more competition today than there was when this was getting 5-star reviews across the board 5 years ago. Just some of my recent reviews, such as the Bang & Olufsen P6 wireless speaker, are exactly the kind of device this is now going up against. In fact, there are so many brands, I'm not even going to try and list the competition. But can this little speaker really hold up? Well, in terms of looks, I think it still looks good today. You have a rather nice aluminium and black front. You have the same aluminium design on the back. You have this rubber surround all the way around it. You either like that or you don't. Personally, I don't, but I think that's a personal preference thing. And then you have this really cool honeycomb structure. Now, I remember when this launched, that honeycomb structure looked amazing in the promotional photos. The thing is, if you see it in person, the actual plastic in front of this is slightly smoked, so it kind of detracts away from the looks. Overall, though, I don't think we can really knock it. In terms of specs, so this has two 50mm audio drivers. It speaks about passive bass radiators. Apparently it has two of them. It has, and I'm sorry about this, micro USB, but the micro USB slot can do nothing. It's simply a service connector. It has a reset switch, haven't seen one of those in a while, an aux input, and it has a power connector for its proprietary connector that it comes with. The speaker is very heavy. It weighs about 1 kilogram, but the plus side of that is that it has, I think it is 18 hours of battery life. That's a lot, even by today's standards. And I think that's one of the few things that helps it to stand out in the market, even with so much more competition. The thing is though, Bowers & Wilkins is one of the audio greats. They have produced some incredible products over the years, including the Nautilus speakers. If you don't know about them, look them up. They are simply immense. So they have something of a reputation to uphold, and I don't get it, to be honest with you. The audio quality from this speaker is, in today's standards, in my view, not that great. Sure, it sounds crisp and clear. It does sound very good listening to someone like Nora Jones. But if you put it up against something more complex, whether that's Bonobo or Radiohead, it very quickly feels out of its depth. Part of the reason, I think, is their focus on bass, of which, in my opinion, there is very little. This has led to something I've seen in speakers before, which is when you're listening to bass-heavy music, you will actually hear a dip in volume as you as the bass is essentially trying to play. That can be very off-putting. It essentially drops the volume of the rest of the track in order to try and pump out more bass, and the result is so sort of bass. You can kind of hear it, but the rest of the sound has sort of disappeared. So you listen to a more complex track and it simply becomes very muddy. As I said though, it's capable of these very clear, crisp tones. So I would perhaps imagine that someone that listens to classical music, or indeed jazz, would probably enjoy the sound from this quite a lot. But if you're listening to anything with deep, heavy bass, or even modern pop music, you're probably gonna struggle with sound quality issues. And I was really surprised because this has 5-star reviews literally everywhere. I guess when it launched, it perhaps was more impressive than it is today, but I don't think this is a £250 speaker. If I was forced to give it a star rating, I would say 2.5 to 3 at best. And that's saying something given the great battery life. I just think in today's market, you can do better. I would really push you to, once we're out of lockdown, if you're watching this and we still are, to go to a shop and actually test these out. Go to somewhere that has a range of speakers that you can try, and you'll probably find that there might be something from Bang & Olufsen or Sony, or I think even Sonos makes some speakers with batteries in nowadays, that you might prefer, because I don't think the sound on this is as good as you're going to expect. Perhaps you might be lulled into thinking that it is better than it is if you just buy this and don't listen to something else. So ideally, find somewhere you can compare it to something else. That's not to say this is a bad buy. If you are happy with the sound quality, sure, go out and buy one, but please don't spend £250 on one. You can do better, and perhaps if you can pick one up for closer to £150, maybe then it makes a bit more sense, but I certainly wouldn't want to spend retail price. So that's what I think of the Bowers & Wilkins T7 wireless Bluetooth speaker. It's not a bad speaker, but it's no longer great, and it's certainly not deserving of that rather large price tag today. I hope you found this useful. If you have any other questions about the Bowers & Wilkins T7, or if you completely disagree with me, pop it in the comments below. It'd be interesting to hear what you think. Equally, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already. Really appreciate it. And thank you very much for watching. I hope to see you again next time. Goodbye.